Akira Yoshino was 9 years old when he discovered the book The Chemical History of a Candle. It told of the energy stored inside a candle and of the chemistry behind it when it was used. Reading that book shaped his entire life. Inspired by it, Akira Yoshino came up with a modern means for energy storage, one that would shape our world. Tablets, digital cameras, smartphones, none of them would work without the lithium-ion battery. Akira Yoshino was the man who invented it. He made it possible. At the beginning of the digital lifestyle revolution, the big buzzwords were portable, cordless, and wireless. But nobody really knew what kind of rechargeable battery was going to be needed to make that work. But at least there was a trend. I headed in that direction, and I think I had a pretty good sense of smell. The future demanded a small, lightweight, and above all, rechargeable battery. Developing it seemed an impossible mission at the time. But the chemist and engineer took up the challenge. At the chemical company Asahi Kasei, Akira Yoshino set out in search of an entirely new chemistry for a completely different kind of battery. He knew that inside it, the electric charge would have to flow in a completely new way. So, Yoshino experimented with lithium cobalt oxide. Could the material function as a positive electrode? When energized, it could indeed release charged particles, lithium ions. But Yoshino still had no negative electrode that could also absorb and store lithium ions adequately enough. This is why the chemist developed a new material, carbon with a special crystalline structure. It could just make the new battery work. But there was a further problem, the aqueous electrolyte solution, through which the electrical charge flowed from one electrode to the other in previous rechargeable batteries. Yoshino had to reinvent it. Previously, rechargeable batteries used water as the solvent for the electrolyte. However, over 1.5 volts cannot be used. So I used organic solvent instead of water, and I was able to get over 4 volts. And indeed, Yoshino scored a major success. When voltage is applied, the lithium atoms in the positive electrode each lose one electron. They become lithium ions, and they migrate to the negative electrode, where they capture their electrons again. The battery is charged. During discharging, it's the same process, but the other way around. The battery releases the electrons and supplies electricity, while all the lithium ions migrate back to the positive electrode. Usual battery technology uses the principle of chemical transformation in the electrodes during charging and discharging. This chemical reaction and transformation makes the battery get weaker when repeatedly recharged. In a lithium ion battery, there is no chemical transformation, only lithium ions moving back and forth. And that's exactly why it could be charged and discharged again and again without getting weaker. But Yoshino's mission wasn't over just yet. To ensure that the current could flow quickly enough during charging and discharging, the electrodes needed to have a large surface area. Yoshino devised coating the electrode materials on metal foil. The key, using aluminium foil for the positive current collector. Yoshino's biggest challenge, however, was proving the safety of the new batteries. When people tried to make rechargeable batteries using metallic lithium, they heated up quickly and uncontrollably during charging and discharging. Some even caught fire or exploded. That made them far too dangerous. But Akira Yoshino solved this problem too. he developed a wafer-thin plastic membrane for placement between the electrodes. If the battery got too hot, the pores inside the membrane would close, and the lithium ions could no longer migrate. The charging process would be interrupted. Anxiously, Yoshino began testing the first of his new batteries. To his relief, nothing happened. So, his lithium-ion battery had passed the test. I was nervous at first, but relieved to see that this test proved the lithium-ion battery to be safe. The final step was developing a process for mass production. And the lithium-ion battery was ready for the market. In no time at all, it has conquered our everyday life. Not just because of the many inventions in the battery, but also because of Asahi Kasei's patent licensing strategy. The policy to license patents made it possible for many companies to manufacture lithium-ion batteries. That was important for the growth of the lithium-ion battery market and built up trust with customers. Everyone could benefit very quickly from the new technology. And that's the point of inventions. They should be accessible to satisfy the needs of the world. For 30 years now, Akira Yoshino has dedicated himself to the development of the lithium-ion battery. Again and again, he has considered how it can be made even better and even more reliable. He is named as an inventor on 56 Japanese and 6 European patents, thanks to his tireless creativity. I've found that it's more likely for a good technology idea to pop into my head when I'm relaxing, with a clear mind, rather than when I'm concentrating hard, trying to think of something. Akira Yoshino is now 71 years old, and he's still doing research into the electric car of the future. A kind of mobile living space where you can consume media or work like in an office. Self-driving, of course, with electric power for 800 kilometers range. A vision that needs another new kind of energy storage. It could just be that the world is about to be radically changed once again. By inventions from Akira Yoshino.